before we leave.
I think you're okay, right, if you stay kind of there. Oh, you know, I'll come in, bud, and I'll take your call back.
Who knows?
$5,500 with the carburetor and everything on it, then I'll keep it for my Camaro.
Blustery Sunday evening, I guess you could say. It's getting pretty bad out there, snow and ice and stuff. Obviously, it's causing behind us, and we got a nice little armrest here for somewhere between us, I guess, anyone I'm going to say right now. So, whatever, we'll figure it out. So, Bryon, so tell us about your car for starters.
The 83 Olds Cutlass. I've had it since I was 17, bought it in 1988. Started out as a V6. The only option it had was air conditioning, and you know, I just kept building from there.
Yeah. How long have you been racing the car now?
I've been racing the car probably, I would say, early 90s probably, somewhere around there. Yeah.
So was that your first race car?
Yeah. Like I say, it was just a progression, right? I had a small block in it at first, just a stock small block, probably run 16s or something with it, and you know, and then I got the bug, right?
Yeah.
You know, a friend of mine took me to the track, and that was it. Just keeps on going.
So would you say your friend influenced you into the racing thing, or you just
I would say so.
Yeah, was he a racer too, or?
Yeah.
That's cool.
Yeah, he was. He would have his Mustang then, I guess, right? Yellow Mustang.
Yeah. So tell us a bit about yourself. What do you do? Who you are?
I own a body shop. Mm-hmm. Been in the body shop industry over 30 years. Mm-hmm. You know, I own a body shop with my wife, Teresa.
She sells cars on the side, right? Yeah. Okay. What else we got here? Who's your biggest supporter?
My biggest supporter?
Yeah.
I would say Teresa is.
Yeah. Number one fan too? Or?
Yeah. Biggest supporter, biggest fan.
Yeah.
Turns the nitrous on for me.
Yeah.
That's good. Yeah. Heating up bottles, checking tire pressures, you know, videoing the passes.
Data logger.
A lot of work, yeah.
Out of all your years of racing, what sticks out the most?
Probably the last two.
Yeah.
With the OSO, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, probably the last two with the OSO.
Yeah.
Yeah, had a really good year the first year, and this past year, you know, there's been some growing pains with the car, but, you know, it's coming around, and it overall was another good year.
Yeah. Yeah. So where all have you raced? Just TNP, or are you doing...
No, I haven't been south of the border, but I've raced at Grand Bend, St. Thomas, Toronto Motorsports Park. I have raced at up in North Bay.
Mm-hmm. What's your favorite part of being involved with OSO?
Favorite part? I would say the people.
Yeah.
A lot of good people in the OSO, and, you know, get to hang out with some. Mark Roberts, maybe not so much. Eric Weber, he kind of gets on me a little bit, but
yeah. Eric's a good guy too. So.
Yeah. Oh yeah.
Oh, they're all good guys.
Yeah.
So.
Oh yeah. A lot of good guys.
What do you see yourself as far as racing in the next 5 years? Like same car, new car?
No, that car. I'll keep that car for a while.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. You talked about your Camaro. You think it might come out at all, or?
We'll have to see.
Yeah.
We'll have to see how that goes. I'm just kind of playing that one by ear.
Yeah.
We'll see, you know.
Okay.
It'd be a nice car done. I'm not sure. Like I say, I'm just not sure which way to go with that one yet.
Mm-hmm. Any changes for the car next year?
Just upgrading the carburetor.
Mm-hmm.
You know, that's pretty much it.
Yep.
Maybe hit it with a bit more nitrous.
If you could bring a new idea into the series, what would you bring in?
New idea.
Like, what do you think would bring more people or racers or?
That's a good question.
I need somebody to answer it for me. So.
You know, I always thought this about the other series I used to run in is like a truck class.
Yeah.
Right. Like you've got all these guys.
I said that too.
Mark.
You know, the diesel diesel trucks with all the diesel trucks, right? The
big
4x4 diesel trucks and stuff, right?
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
Right. I don't see a place where they would race at all.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Right. I don't see a series for them guys. Right. So I think that would be a good start.
So I guess basically tell us about your car now. Like what's in it now, and what all have you done to it? And
well, it's kind of slow. But yeah, I got the Shaproff big block Chev in it, 598 cubic inch.
Mm-hmm.
You know, just a pump gas, you know, street motor. You can go to the Petro-Can, fill it up, and you can drive it anywhere you want, you know. And, it's, I don't know what much more than that, you know. Got a Hutch 400 in it, 9-inch board from Strange. That was new, upgraded this year. That's why next year is going to be a little bit slower. We spent a bit of money on it this year. So.
Yeah.
What else I could tell you about? It's heavy.
Yeah.
And 3,900 pounds with me in it.
Wow.
You know, it's, I think that's most of my issues is trying to get it up and going, right?
So you just won the shootout at St. Thomas there a few weeks ago.
Yeah.
Top competition there?
Yeah, there was a lot of fast stuff there.
Yeah. Is that the first shootout you won?
Yeah.
Do you do more shootouts?
Would I do more?
Yeah.
Oh yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. You know, if I got time, right? So.
Yeah.
This should have been a little tough for time, right?
The yeah.
Little stretched, right? So.
if you had a chance to race anybody from the Street Outlaw Show, who would it be?
From Oklahoma?
Yeah.
You know, I think it would be fun to race farm truck.
Yeah.
I think it might, I don't know if it'd be a good match or not, but, I think those guys would be fun to race. I think the other guys are just out of my league, right?
Mm-hmm.
You know, like racing 10 and a half outlaw cars, right? I mean, this car's not there, right? So, farm truck might be a good race.
Yeah. Basically, that's it.
Sit. There you go.